Mats Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Madu.
Six, hello, this is Teacher Paul, ready to present a lesson on plants and specifically on pollination. And I want to start by defining the term pollination. Pollination is simply, pollination is the transfer of pollen grain from the under of the plant, from the under to the stigma. That is what we call pollination, the transfer of pollen grain from the under to the stigma. And to make you understand, we looked at the part of a flower and we saw that there is this part of a flower. That's the female part of a flower. And we also have the male part of a flower. This part is what we are calling the anther, and this is what we call the stigma of the flower, the stigma. So when I'm saying that it is a transfer, I'm referring the movement of pollen grain from here to here. And what is pollen grain? Pollen grain is the male sex cells of a plant, Then, this is the stigma where it falls. We have types of pollination. We have two types of pollination. We have what you call the self-pollination, and we also have what you call the cross-pollination. There are two types of pollination, the self-pollination and the cross-pollination. To make you understand, let me still use this part of my word and say that in the types of pollination, to start with the self, it is the pollination that takes place within the same plant. For example, this is a flower. These are the anthers and the stigma. This is the stalk. These are the sepals. And then this flower is in this plant. Then the same, there is another flower in the same plant. When the pollen grain leaves here and falls in the stigma of the other flower, but the flower is still within the same plant, we say that this is self-pollination. The plant has pollinated itself. There is self-pollination. We can also have a flower pollinating itself. This is the other branch where we have got the flower and the anther here. Then the anther here, although in an insect pollinated flower, the anthers are supposed to be found inside the flower, where the pollen grain falls from here to here, within the same flower. So self, the key point is the same plant. It should occur on the same plant. It is the transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma within the same plant, or within the same flower. Well, on the other hand, we have the term cross-pollination. This is where we have a plant. Then we have got a flower. Then we have got another plant of the same kind. Then pollination occurs from one flower to the other. The transfer of pollen grain from the other to the other flower, from this flower to another flower, in a different plant, but of the same kind. If it is maize, then maize. but not in the same plant. Nothing, there's no relationship with the same plant. That's the time you use the word cross-pollination. Cross-pollination. And I want to show you a practical example of the cross-pollination. Here is a plant. Which plant is this? Which plant is this? This is a maize plant. This is the female part of a flower. This is the female part of a flower. While this is the male part of a flower. This one is a bit better. It is the same thing. This is the male part of a flower. While this one is the female part of a flower. Maize is a special plant. It has got the male and the female part of a flower at different positions. At different positions. So when this is a pollen grain, I want you to look at the powder falling. This is what we call the pollen grain. This is what we call the pollen grain. When it falls here, these ones are the styles. The tip of this is the stigma. So when this pollen grain falls here, that transfer is what I'm calling pollination. Which type of pollination is this? It is within the same plant. Which one is this? This is self. The plant has pollinated itself. So with time, this pollen, it looks large in size, but the only important thing, there's a middle part of this pollen grain we call the nucleus. It cannot be seen. The pollen grain may be seen, but the nucleus cannot be seen. Though the moment the nucleus touches here, it flows through the style. It flows through the style up to where we have each style here represents a seed. So I want to show you what really happens. I'm interfering with the female part of a flower. I have uncovered the sepals. These are the sepals. Not this, because they are green in color, they are the sepals. These are the styles, and each style is a seed. So once the pollen grain falls here, it flows through the stigma, the styles, up to where we have the ovary. These are the ovary. Each seed is an ovary. But in maize, we don't call them seeds, we call them fruits. Each fruit is an ovary. It's an ovary. So that process is known as pollination. I've explained pollination. Now in maize, because it is from here to here, it is self. But if you have another plant here, we would call it cross, but maize for maize. We have another plant here. Which plant is this? This is a pawpaw plant. This is a pawpaw plant, and it has flowers. Special thing about a pawpaw is that pawpaw, you must plant two trees. You must plant the male plant and the female plant. You must plant the male plant and the female plant. So in a pawpaw, we have got one plant, which is male. We also have got another plant, which is female. It only happens in pawpaw. So the transfer of pollen grain in a pawpaw is always cross. It is always cross-pollination. But in maize, we have seen it can be self. At the same time, it can be cross. Different plants or within the same plant. This is self, this is cross. But in a pawpaw, it is compulsory cross-pollination. Cross-pollination. So let me define pollination by saying that self-pollination is the transfer of pollen grain from the anther, that's it, anther, to the stigma. That is the description of pollination alone. Now to tell you it is self, add the other statement. It is the transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma within the same plant. Within the same plant all within the same flower. And we have seen that. So that you can define cross as cross pollination. We can define this one as the transfer of foreign grain from the anther to the stigma. That is pollination. The remaining part of the sentence defines what is cross pollination. To the stigma of another flower in a different plant, but of the same kind. Maize for maize, bean for beans, pawpaw for pawpaw. Then we have seen that a pawpaw is special. What is special about pawpaw? It has a male and a female plant. A male and a female plant independently. What have you seen about maize? Special thing about maize is that the part of the flower, the male part and female part are at different positions. Then we have seen that hanging things are the styles. The tip of the style is the stigma. Then, adding on that, we want to look at a different concept, what we call insect-pollinated flowers and wheat-pollinated flowers. We have what can make pollen grains fall from one point to another. We call them agents of pollination. We have one, there are two major, one of them is the insects, the other one are the birds, and we also have the weed. These are the four things that can make pollen grain to transfer from one point to another. And in the next lesson, I'll take you through insect pollinated flowers, and I'll also take you through weed pollinated flowers. What have we learned? We have learned what the term pollination, we have defined the term, the types of pollination. We have also seen the maize and the pawpaw. Otherwise, thank you for listening. Read more from the notes.